Hey YouTube, JW. Got another edition of New Arrivals for you guys. First up, this is a nice FHM Filipino handmade butterfly balsong. Nice bone handles. It's a large model. Bottle opener with the three holes. Things that you see quite frequently, and different versions of this. I really like this one. It's got a just got a good look to it. And as far as FHMs go, I think this is a more modern version. How old, I don't really know. Got it from a guy in California who had a bunch of them. They all looked about the same, different sizes. And since they are handmade knives, you don't really have any way of knowing unless you know the maker. This is definitely a nice one. See, it's not real sharp. Nice collector's piece. I have quite a few FHM. Stick with the two balsong butterflies first. Black Sting, Fury Japan, new old stock, classic pattern. You know, all these Japanese makers are importers, like Fury, CI, Compass, Frost, Taylor. They all shared, for the most part, the same patterns, all made in the same place in Japan, maybe Seki, but they just were stamped for different makers, but they all shared pretty much the same patterns. And this is a good example of one of those. Different makers might put a little bit of their own flavor on it, but it's the same pattern. Got another Japan. This is a Fury keychain. Yeah. Push dagger. It's got a little compartment here. Put something in. Maybe some pills or something. Very big. Wouldn't want to get punched with that though. Got a little twist there too, and the handle's kind of unique. Another push dagger. I got this cheap. Whether it was painted black or not, I don't really know. It may have been stripped at one time. Most of them, I've had several of these before. Most of them you see are Parker Widowmakers, typically. This is a C, I think this is a CI or a Compass. Compass brand. Japan Texas Wildcat. Push dagger, classic 80s Japan design, been used for sure. Got another Japan, something that doesn't really have a lot of value, and is like many others, but this being camo, number one, I just really never see the camo ones, and if you do, they've either been stripped, I'd say it's probably mid 80s, they've either been stripped or the sheath is always gone. And you know, they were throwing knives, so they were thrown, the paint would wear off, so they're either all beat to piss, they got lost, because throwing knives are hard enough to find, that I'm being camo. So the fact that this one is basically never been used. You can tell by the tip of that that it's never been thrown. So it's really not worth that much, but try finding another one type deal. Let's see. Japan. New old stock. Parker. You can still buy these types of knives, I'm pretty sure. But this being nice condition. New old stock. Japan. Lipstick knife. Twist it to open. Parker number there. Early K series. Taiwan. Early 90s. Starting to get into the pocket clip. Maybe mid 90s. I remember seeing these in magazines. Sitting in school when I was supposed to be doing school work. Remember the heartbreaker blade pattern with the heart. Liner lock. You know, I got it cheap. I just remember the pattern, and typically they're all beat up, or you know, you don't see them a whole lot. Blackie Collins. Strut and cut. One of the first assisted knives, kind of a funky design. Turn this. Red, you're dead. You got this wheel. Got probably about 97 or 1998, 99, you know, around 2000, going from the late 90s. .com folder. Knives always like the cheap knives, especially always still to this day, like to capitalize on current things that are going on to try to get people to buy them. Like Frost, they'll put little etchings of, you know, like for example, I remember when they killed Osama bin Laden. I guess it's been a while now, but they had, you know, they just come up with little shit to commemorate that or whatever. And this was during that, you know, .com boom. It just kind of took everything over in the late 90s. And they decided to, and I thought that just really represented that time period well. Frost for a stamp, China. It's a classic Frost knife from that era. Just kind of neat. And once again, one you just don't see very much. And with the box, the, you know, the, a lot of times there's a knife that, you know, if it didn't have the box, I probably wouldn't have bought it. Got a few packaged ones here. Wrap this one up. Key Guard. United Cutlery. Taiwan. Looks like a Tecna. Extra Guard. sure that's what this, those are made in Japan. Sure that's what this is based off of. Once again, you just don't see them with the box. You know, made it for me with the box. This as well. Taylor locomotive. Classic early 80s brass knife. 1981. These early Taylor knives, a lot of time, always had the date. You see a lot of 80, 81, 82. I've seen 83. You see a lot of 1980 and a lot of 1982s for some reason. I'm not sure why. Not least, switchblade pen. The ink is dried up in it. Switchblade pen, patent pending. British patent. Push button, snap, it's open. Ballpoint pen. Hex Company. Lift locking tab with fingernail fold closed. Extra refills. Chicago, Illinois. That's it. So I brought down for this another exciting edition of New Arrivals. Seems to be a popular series of videos. I haven't done one since March, so I haven't really been getting near as many knives. I've been doing other things, so there might be a few other ones laying around that I forgot about, but yeah, I've slowed down considerably on buying. I've actually was selling some stuff to some collectors. I'm just running out of room. I'm getting knives everywhere. Got no place to go with them. So that's it for this edition of Retro Knives. I appreciate you guys watching, as always, and I'll get back with you when I can.